In this exercise, I would like for us to take this piecewise defined function and compute all of its directional derivatives at the origin. Then we will show that even though all directional derivatives exist, the function still fails to be differentiable at the origin. So there are two goals to this video. The first one is to show a way to systematically crank out every possible directional derivative, even though there are infinitely many. So I'll take you through that computation. The second goal is to again hammer home this message that the existence of partial derivatives does not guarantee differentiability. Here we're taking it even further. Not only does this function have partial derivatives at the origin, it has every directional derivative. Like if you walk from the origin in any straight line ray out from the origin, the function seems to behave well, and yet it still fails to be differentiable. So there are two goals to this exercise. Let's start with the first one. We would like to compute all of the directional derivatives for this function at the origin. Here's what I'm going to do is I'm going to say u, call it u hat, it's unit length. Its coordinates are u1, u2. This is going to be the unit vector we use to describe the direction we're moving when we compute the directional derivative. So since this is unit length, u1 squared plus u2 squared is 1. Let me set up the difference quotient that we need in order to compute directional derivatives at the origin, and then I'll let you simplify a little bit, come back, wrap it all up. But here's the direction we're moving. So they do exist. I'll go ahead and say the directional derivative of f at the origin in the direction indicated by this random unit vector is the limit as t goes to 0 of f at the origin. So let me write 0, 0 plus t times u. I'll write u hat here, but you could also do t times u1, u2 minus f at the origin. So it's like a change, and then divide by t to get the rate of change. Okay, here's the difference quotient we need. Take this as far as you can, and then I will come back and we will complete this limit so that we can say what every possible directional derivative is. All right, let's see how you did. I'm going to start simplifying this. The limit as t goes to 0, this is just f of t u1 t u2. We know that at the origin, f takes the value 0, and then we are dividing by t. So let's evaluate this. I'll pull the 1 over t in front, and then what is t u1 t u2? That's going to be t cubed u1 cubed divided by t squared u1 squared plus t squared u2 squared. All right, this right here is just t squared because u1 squared plus u2 squared is 1. So overall, this denominator is t squared. That means, keep working with this marker, we have t cubed and then t times t squared. So t cubed, t, and t squared all cancel. Now we are left with just u1 cubed. So the directional derivative for this function at the origin in the direction of any unit vector u can be computed as the cube of the first coordinate of u. So the next question is this function differentiable? Kind of already stated that it isn't, but let's see how to get there. To assess differentiability, we want to put together the Jacobian matrix. So I'm actually not going to do the whole grand definition of differentiability if that's what you think we're about to do, but you can try that. I'm actually going to give you a shortcut, but it will involve needing the Jacobian matrix for this function at the origin. It's going to be the partial derivative of this function with respect to x at the origin and then with respect to y. Well, what is the partial derivative with respect to x? Keep in mind that the partial derivative with respect to x is like saying the directional derivative of f at this point in the direction of 1, 0. Well, we just said how to do this, so we don't need to compute this again. The first coordinate is 1, cube it, and you get 1. And then similarly, the directional derivative of f at the origin in the direction of 0, 1 is the same thing as df dy at the origin. So 0 cubed is 0. Okay, so this was 1 cubed, 0 cubed. I got that right from the computation we already did, so you don't need to do the partial derivatives on their own. I just said that I'm not going to take this matrix and this function and basically plug them into the definition of differentiability to see if the definition is satisfied. In fact, it's not. What I'm going to do instead is rely on a formula that we have already proved, which is if a function is differentiable, then there's a special way to compute directional derivatives. So I'm going to step aside so that I can actually give myself room to do the computation, but take a moment to see if you remember what that is. We had a theorem that said that if, big if f is differentiable at the origin here, then directional derivatives can be computed via a dot product. So in particular, the directional derivative of f at the origin in the direction of u could be done by taking the dot product of the gradient with u. So let me write that as, I'll write out the formula. Okay, so dot product of f, the gradient of f rather at the origin with u. Okay, so this formula is true if f is differentiable. But let's see what both sides of this equality look like for this particular function. Here, we just said that this is u1 cubed. On the other hand, the gradient of f is the vector 1, 0. If I dot that with u1, u2, I get u1. It is not the case in general that u1 cubed is u1. That would only be true, say, along the coordinate axes when u1 is either 0 or plus minus 1. So in general, this formula does not hold, which means that this function is not differentiable at the origin. So kind of a fun exercise. What I would like to do is step away for a moment and we're done. So I'm just going to put up a graphic of this function. I'm going to take the graph of this function, it's a surface in R3, and kind of slowly spin it around. And what you'll notice is that the directional derivatives should look like they exist, which means from the origin, if you radiate outwards in any straight line sense of direction, you'll see there's a reasonable sense of like the rate of change in that direction. And yet, I think it's really visible from certain angles in the rotation, you'll see that this, the graph of this function looks like it has kind of a corner right at the origin, indicating that there isn't like a nice tangent plane that we could lay against our function at that point. So our function is not differentiable. Okay, thank you for your attention.